At this point, we have seen how to handle static data, how to capture and replay user interaction, and even a generic mechanism to record and replay the interaction with the environment. Let me now briefly discuss some additional items that are of particular importance during debugging. The key concept for all of these is to make non-deterministic behavior deterministic and controllable at the same time. First, time. If your program depends on real dates and times, be sure to provide a means to set these for diagnostic purposes. If it depends on real timing, make these limits controllable as well. Second, randomness. If your program has planned non-deterministic behavior, for instance, if you're building a game, ensure that you can reproduce this at will. If you use a pseudo-random generator, be sure to save its seed. If you use a true random generator, save the sequence of random numbers. Third, schedules. Multi-thread programs may non-deterministically switch between threads. Again, find means to make these thread switches deterministic. Otherwise, you may run into hard-to-reproduce thread scheduling issues. Fourth, physical influence. Depending on your environment, it is possible that some physical influence causes software errors. If you place a strong alpha emitter on top of your CPU or your RAM, this will likely cause malfunctions. Cosmic rays may also result in spurious errors. But this is more an electronics problem rather than a software problem, so we leave it as it is. Fifth, debugging tools. Debuggers instrument the code and alter its execution. The least they do is to influence the real timing. Therefore, they may induce Heisenbugs, again, bugs that appear or disappear when being observed.